Earth 2100. Prepare for a very different planet. We all know that our fossil fuel-based lifestyle is leaving a climate crisis for billions of people in the future. But when we say future, how far ahead should we be thinking? Until 2050? 2100? Or perhaps a bit further? Maybe 2500 and beyond? You might have noticed that the climate projections used by international scientific and political communities generally extend to only up to the year 2100. The simple reason for this is that it is impossible to predict with any accuracy the amount of greenhouse gases that will be released in the coming centuries and how this will affect the climate. But don't be fooled. This does not mean that climate change will cease to be a problem in the years beyond the maximum range of our most cited climate forecasts. The shocking truth is that climate change is just the beginning. Regardless of future emission trends, the CO2 footprint of our brief time on Earth will remain in the climate system and impact the well-being of all forms of terrestrial life for what could be considered almost an eternity. In this video, we will try to condense all the data we have gathered to offer you a vision of our planet as it will be in 2100 if we fail to find a solution. Most of us really want to build better learning habits, but we either have none or can't stay focused long enough to research and absorb everything. So, we spend our spare time mindlessly scrolling, making us feel unsatisfied and unfulfilled. Until now. Until Imprint. Imprint is an app that makes learning quick, engaging, and most importantly, fun. It contains a variety of beautifully illustrated courses, like the Succeed in Business course I took, designed to fit perfectly into your busy schedules. The courses are divided into super short, bite-sized lessons. The science-based lessons teach you from the ground up, making it easy to understand, absorb, and deep dive into each subject. From psychology, philosophy, and the science of happiness to productivity systems, finance, technology, health, and more, Imprint has something for everyone. So, how about trying out Imprint and taking the Succeed in Business course for yourself to see exactly what I'm talking about? Thanks to our partnership, you can explore Imprint free for 7 days and get 20% off the annual plan. Just scan this QR code or click the link in the description. In just under 80 years, Earth will no longer be the same. By 2100, global warming could cause such significant changes in local temperatures and precipitation that it will force a redesign of the climate zone map for nearly half of the planet's land areas, with the most significant changes observable at the poles in Europe and North America. Simulating the predicted changes for 2100 with the most up-to-date climate models, it emerges that up to 40% to 50% of the land areas could find themselves projected into a new climate zone, with severe consequences for agriculture, the spread of diseases, and the survival of many species. According to the analysis, the tropical climate could expand from 23% to 25% of the land areas, while arid zones would increase from 31% to 34%. Very noticeable changes are expected in the cold climate zones of Europe and North America, which could slip into a new climate zone with 90% and 66% of their territory, respectively. The most dramatic changes could affect the polar zone, which, at the beginning of the 20th century, represented 8% of the land areas, while today it has already shrunk to 5.5%. The current concentration of CO2 is higher than at any other time in the last 15 million years, as indicated by paleoclimatic and geological evidence. The global average temperature is now about 0.8 degrees higher than pre-industrial levels and continues to rise. The planet's oceans continue to warm, with about 90% of the excess heat trapped by rising greenhouse gas concentrations since 1955 stored in the oceans as heat. Meanwhile, the rate of ice loss has more than tripled since the 1993 to 2003 period. Arctic sea ice reached a record low in September of 2023, and half the average minimum sea ice extent since 1979. The average sea level rise was about 15 to 20 centimeters globally over the 20th century, and is now increasing by about 1.25 inches or 3.2 centimeters per decade. If this rate remains unchanged, it would mean that over 30 centimeters of additional sea level rise in the 21st century. There's also an observed increase in the frequency and intensity of heat waves, with some regions experiencing more intense extreme precipitation and drought. Observations indicate a tenfold increase in the area of the planet experiencing extreme heat since the 1950s. What climate changes are expected with a 4 degrees Celsius increase in global temperature? The greatest warming will occur on land, ranging from 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. Increases of 6 degrees Celsius or more in average summer monthly temperatures are expected in vast regions of the world, including the Mediterranean, North Africa, and the Middle East. Almost all summer months are likely to be hotter than the most extreme heat waves currently experienced. And for example, the hottest July in the Mediterranean region could be 9 degrees Celsius hotter than the hottest July today. Recent extreme heat waves like those of 2024 will likely become the norm in a world with 4 degrees Celsius temperatures. Tropical South America, Central Africa, and all tropical Pacific islands will likely regularly experience unprecedented heat waves in scope and duration. In this new high-temperature climate regime, the coldest months will likely be substantially warmer than the hottest months of the late 20th century. At this point, one might ask, in the face of such apocalyptic scenarios, what is being done in the present? Practically nothing is the answer. Greenhouse gas emissions, far from decreasing, are higher than ever and still rising. The last time we witnessed such dramatic change was during the end of the last ice age, when much of Central Europe and northern United States were covered by kilometers of ice. With one small but substantial difference, however, the extreme nature of the transformations is not only due to the unprecedented rate of temperature increase, but also to the speed at which these transformations are occurring. We are talking about changes that once took 10 to 20,000 years, now happening in a century or two. The results could prove even more drastic, as ecosystem warming, invasive species, and habitat fragmentation could create reinforcing feedback loops, accelerating the process and leading to more frequent extreme events. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. So, what will the world look like in 2100 due to climate change? If the currently planned actions are not fully implemented, a 4 degrees Celsius warming could occur as early as 2060. Such a level of warming by 2100 would not be the end point. Further warming to levels above 6 degrees Celsius would likely occur in the following centuries. The impacts are likely to hit the poorest regions of the world hardest, as they have less economic, institutional, scientific, and technical capacity to cope with the danger and adapt. Small island developing states and least developed countries have identified a global warming of 1.5 degrees Celsius as the level above which there would be severe threats to their development and, in some cases, their survival. For small island states and river delta regions, sea level rise will likely have far-reaching negative consequences, especially when combined with the predicted increased intensity of tropical cyclones, the loss of protective coral reefs due to rising temperatures, and ocean acidification. Changes in winds and ocean currents due to global warming and other factors will also affect regional sea level rise, as will patterns of heat absorption and ocean warming. Although absolute warming will be greater at higher latitudes, the warming that will occur in the tropics is greater compared to the historical range of temperatures and extremes to which human and natural ecosystems have adapted and responded. The predicted emergence of unprecedented high-temperature extremes in the tropics will consequently lead to significantly greater impacts on agriculture and ecosystems. Sea level rise in tropical regions is likely to be 15 to 20% higher than the global average. Similarly, the increased intensity of tropical cyclones will disproportionately affect low-latitude regions, and aridity and drought will substantially increase in many developing regions. But that's not all. Vast areas of London, New York, Bangkok, and other major cities will likely be underwater by the end of the century. As a result of rising water levels, coastlines will be significantly altered, and many cities will become uninhabitable, forcing hundreds of millions of people to relocate. New altitude data, maps, and analyses document how, by the end of this century, at-risk areas worldwide will extend several kilometers inland, and water will advance over areas where about 93 million people live today. Based on this, nearly 100 major cities worldwide will need to implement unprecedented defenses to avoid losing most of their populated areas. According to maps modeled by researchers, low-lying London will be one of the main Western cities most affected, while parts of northern France, Belgium, Germany, and the Netherlands will also be flooded by 2100. In the United States, sea level rise and flooding will likely submerge parts of New York, Newark, and Jersey City, along with the southern coast of Long Island, New Orleans, Los Angeles, and Oakland. If global temperatures rise above 3 degrees Celsius, Miami will likely be completely submerged and cease to exist as a city. However, it is expected that the Asian population will be the most affected by sea level rise. If the average global temperature on the surface of the land and oceans increases by more than 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels by the end of the century, the effects will be disastrous for Asian countries and those bordering the Pacific. Huge cities like Shanghai in China, Bangkok in Thailand, and Ho Chi Minh City in Vietnam will be at extreme risk of flooding, displacing millions of inhabitants and causing a massive humanitarian crisis. Ensuring food security across the continent will become increasingly difficult, and numerous conflicts over resource control will arise. This could lead to mass migrations. The number of people forced to leave their homes could reach the staggering figure of 1 billion. Moreover, if the current trend indicates a possible average increase of 4 degrees, in some regions the figure would be significantly higher. In Tajikistan, Afghanistan, and Pakistan, as well as in the northwestern part of China, the thermometer could reach 8 degrees higher, making some areas completely uninhabitable. The most affected country will be Bangladesh, already known for being one of the poorest nations in the world. The number of regions at risk by flooding will increase in parallel with the temperature. Sea levels will rise by 2.3 meters for each degree Celsius. Finally, potable water will become an increasingly rare commodity, not only due to climate change, but also because of the population growth the world will face. And in the United States? This summer's heat waves have put about a third of the U.S. population on alert. A heat wave is a period of abnormal heat that usually lasts two or more days, with temperatures exceeding 103 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius. Such periods of intense heat are occurring more frequently in the United States, with an average of 6 per year, and are becoming more intense and longer. The average heat wave season is about 49 days longer today than in the 1960s. Cities are particularly hard hit. Since concrete absorbs heat, cities warm up faster and are less able to cool down compared to other areas. By 2100, hot days reaching dangerous conditions are expected to be 3 to 10 times more frequent in the United States. Some parts of the country could become more attractive, such as those at higher altitudes or with cooler temperatures. The northern U.S., Canada, and even Alaska and the Arctic regions will be swarmed by millions of climate migrants in a century. And although migration is not always a bad thing, choosing to leave an area is very different from being forced to do so. Regarding ice melt, the southeastern United States will be the most affected by sea level rise. Florida is at severe risk, and Georgia, South Carolina, and Louisiana could have over 10% of their population at risk by 2100. Some models predict that the average sea level will rise along the U.S. coast by 2 feet or 60 centimeters by 2100. But more extreme scenarios show it could rise up to 7 feet, more than 2 meters, if we fail to curb future emissions. It's worth noting that according to one study, a sea level rise of just 3 feet, almost 1 meter, would threaten the homes of 4.2 million people. Food supply will also be less secure. It is expected that increased heat and changes in precipitation patterns will damage crop yields across the United States. Corn yields in Iowa, soybean yields in Minnesota, and wheat yields in Kansas will all be 30% lower than today's levels. High temperatures, along with ocean acidification and algal blooms, will also threaten fishing. Some fish like cod are moving north and into deeper waters in response to warmer oceans, and other species like lobsters, oysters, clams, and mussels are at risk of population decline. We should expect not only the emergence of new species compositions, but also a total reconfiguration of ecosystems. Forests would become grasslands, grasslands would turn into deserts, and biodiversity-rich sites would lose most of their surviving species. So there's no point in beating around the bush. The stakes are higher than ever, as our very survival depends on the composition of the ecosystems we live in. Now it's up to us to accelerate the transition to the sustainability we so desperately need. Otherwise, it will be chaos.